Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Metro Exodus. It is your boy Ghost GG back. Continuing, we just escaped Volga, we lost Duke, and now we're on the train heading in the direction we need to be heading, I guess. And yeah, so let's get right back into it.
I'm sorry about Duke. He was just a boy, really. He kept asking me for advice on how to become more attractive to a girl he knew, what to say to her. He couldn't wait to come back to her, proudly wearing scars and medals.
Damn. We lost a brother.
Stay here for a bit, Artyom. This is great. I wish I could stay like this forever. Artyom, when you climbed those ruins back in Moscow, with your radio, did you imagine our life on the surface at all? A home, for one. A place where we could live. A log cabin on the outskirts of a forest. Or how about a bungalow on an ocean shore?
Well, oh, it's about to get free skate.
There's something great in simply going anywhere like this. Together. Through the abandoned stations, the ruins, the wasteland. Especially in our own private compartment. Thinking back, isn't this our honeymoon trip? It certainly feels like one, even though it's a bit late. We've only had some honeymoon sorties at best so far. Alyosha keeps telling everyone Duke could have jumped off the bridge in time. The others are also holding well. But I just unraveled. Of course, I had friends die before. He wasn't looking for death, Duke. He did volunteer for the most dangerous missions, but didn't expect to die. He was looking up to Stepan. Dad, you. Especially you. And he didn't die for nothing, did he? He wanted us to get there, to Yamantau. He wanted us to tell them about Moscow. How we survived there and still haven't given up. How we've been hiding it for so long. But when I think of it being you, and not even knowing for sure, I'd never be able to live through it. So, you think I should just let it all out? I don't think that would make me feel better. I've been thinking, back home, we buried our friends at home, and avenged them at home. That home and life there sucked. We were kept there with chains. No, even worse, with lies. And now we are looking for a new home. But here, it's someone else's home. And we are not invited. Right. I've got to get myself under control. Go. Dad wanted to see you.
Okay. Wait, what happens if I sit down?
Living in a fairy tale. A prince has rescued his princess from a monster-infested dungeon and is taking her to his magic kingdom where they are going to live happily ever after. Do you think we're going to find that kingdom in the end? So, if it's you, I'll be fine anywhere. Live happily ever after. Is the most important part.
Ready, Canel. Warhold here. I'm in Jimete. Over. Canel, come in. Canel, over. That's just great. Well, I'll try later.
Okay, different radio station.
Why are you guys kissing Menshikov's ass so much? How long has it been since he even arrived in Irkutsk? Not even 2 years.
You better reconsider your position on Meshnikov. Did you forget who started trading with the convicts from Zolotoy? Huh?
Well, that was Zahar's idea.
Don't fall off that high horse.
Go to hell, Dan. All right. I can live with listening to Menshikov if you're so fond of him.
Ah, enough of that shit already. The important part is that Irkut is still around, and you guys are too.
You're right. That is the important part. Well, give my regards to Menshikov. Over and out.
You devil. Over and out.
Okay. Ooh, this is just music. Okay, these last three are just music.
How long have you been on the road for? I've been listening to the radio too. And there was not a single transmission about any occupying force.
Oh.
There's so much radio chatter. So many stories. Dad says all those are covert transmissions, that they all have hidden meaning, but why would they be so secretive? Why aren't they using this railroad? Why don't they at least control its T-junctions? Why did they not install any roadblocks? If they're even out here. This is the main transport artery.
Uncle Artyom! Uncle Doctor has already set his shop up!
Ooh.
Wanna go look? It's so cool! Here, Uncle Artyom!
Ah, hi, Artyom. See my new place? Fit for a king, I must say. Ah, what do you think of this workbench, eh? Everything is within reach, yet there's so much space left. Most of the stuff you and the guys found outside and gave to me went into making this workshop happen. So thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
We'll have to keep pitching in like this, too. Looks like we're facing a long journey, and useful things like ammo or equipment don't grow on trees. Plus, the further from Moscow we get, the harder they'll probably be to get. So don't forget to collect all the materials you find to keep us going. There's so many things to do. I haven't decided where I'm going to work on the suits, but I'll have to, and soon. It is high time we fixed our uniforms. Some of our people are starting to look pretty ragged, you know?
I don't want the metal detector on anymore. It's annoying ass sounds.
He didn't hold the back plate anymore. And he just kept joking about it. What was I? Well, I'll be working here from now on.
Okay.
Well, that's it. I bragged enough and won't waste any more of your time. The colonel summoned you.
Then I shall go.
Well, I have stuff to do, too. You guys are fast to break gear, but none too expedient to fix it.
I'm going to talk to him.
A smoke break. That's good.
Oh, this is one mean smoke. Yeah, this is enough. Well, nothing we couldn't take.
Can I smoke the entire thing?
Well, you are the right kind of guys. You, the colonel, Duke, that guy did the smoke.
And no smoke design right there.
Bridge. He was a great guy. May he rest in peace. Yeah. So, what did I want to say? Yes. Thank you. You people accepted me, and I'm a simple guy. I will pay the debt back, okay?
So, how do you like it out here after your tunnels? Freedom, huh?
Sure thing. So much space.
Do you have a sewer machine?
No, I don't.
What's up?
But how are you going to fix the suits then?
Well, like everyone else, I take a thread and a needle, and I use a sail stitch.
Whoa, cool! Can you teach me?
Oh, from all the way back there is showing up?
So, Artyom, are you up for a jam? Come on, pick the guitar up.
So these small things in these games, you know?
Thank you, Stefan.
I'm sorry to ask, Katya, but Nastya's father. He's dead, isn't he? Does Nastya know?
He is. I tried keeping it a secret. Look,
stop with this funeral move!
Artyom, the colonel's waiting for you on the bridge.
You recall how he came back from the library? Same thing here!
Well, yeah, that time he pulled a fast one on us. We had the drinks ready. Sam said everything. Was a good speech, too.
Thanks.
Well, that is true. Don't be shy. So, Sam ends his speech, and then Duke asks, where's my drink?
So that is why I say we should wait. He came back from that library. And this is nothing.
Hey, rabbits.
Thanks to Tokarev. He got the decoder working.
Ark, come in. Come in, Ark. Over.
This is Ark. Identify yourself. Over.
This is Colonel Skitoslav Myonnikov speaking. I'm in command of a special operations force. We have received your signal and are currently heading your way. Still copying it. Over.
Yes, yes. They hear you loud and clear.
Who am I talking to? How do I address you?
The Deputy Chief of Communications Department, Major Ivanov. A moment.
Oh, yes, Major. I understand that the checkup is in order.
Great, Colonel. Emelico? Simply capable. I am sorry for the lack of trust, but as you know, the situation is dire and the enemy is always ready to strike.
I do understand, Major, and I hope that you can tell the leadership that my people are true to their duty and will be at their full disposal as soon as we arrive. Over.
Thank you for the great news. How large is your force, Colonel?
I have a squad of the best operatives the special forces have to offer.
A squad? I see. Well, this is great! Great!
Yes, we are a large force, but we bring a message of extreme importance. We are heading towards you from Sector K6 Alpha. Do you have any data on enemy forces we might encounter on the way? Over.
Just a moment, I have to check. K6 Alpha, you say? As far as I can see, there have been no enemy encounters reported in the area, Colonel. I regret. I must end our conversation here, but know that we are waiting for your arrival. I am making my report immediately, and I am sure the Minister of Defense will be eager to see you.
This is a great honor! Thank you! You think you want more, though? What is the general situation there, Major? Please.
Colonel, sir, you do understand this is classified information. But I do understand you. We are doing fine. Do not worry. Well, see you in the Ark. Over and out.
I serve the people. Over and out.
So, do you get this now, you doubting Thomas? I'm so excited my hands are still shaking. The Minister himself! This is incredible.
Something tells me that was not the
Ark. You should take a look at the map.
The Ark.
As you can see, we're heading almost straight for the Yamantau complex. Katya and Chris tell me that the line there is in decent condition. Surprising, really, taking into account the number of priority targets there. So we can hope for smooth sailing from here and right to the very destination. It's not to take us quite some time to get there. So, Yermak, where were we?
You were saying, it's all about the results.
Okay. Let's just head straight up. Yamantau.
We are approaching the Yamantau bunker, the final destination of our long journey. Direct radio contact with the bunker has completely dissolved Miller's resentment towards me for destroying our previous lives. He is eagerly anticipating the meeting with the Minister of Defense he was promised. Probably such things are important for a career officer. The people, though, are less interested. They are asking important questions. Where are the occupying forces? Why is there just wilderness and people gone wild around? What's stopping the government from restoring the country? What was being done in the last 20 years? Miller believes that we'll get all the answers. He will be pardoned, as well as Anna and I. And we will all return home to the Metro.
The Ural Mountains.
Now I know it for a fact.
Mama, look. Are we going to live here now?
I don't know. Why?
I don't like this place. It's creepy.
Shh. Don't say that.
Cobra Carol, it's getting really hot out here.
Everyone, masks on. Passengers, get inside and put it up tight.
Yes, of course. Come on, Nastya.
No, we'll put my mask on.
We're taking the rail car from here. Wait for Artyom and me.
How about me? You've been dreaming to get here for so long, and are now leaving me behind? Am I your daughter or not?
All right, come with us. Or else I'll never hear the end of it.
A wise decision.
Yermak, stop the engine.
All right, let's transfer over.
Take the Aurora back to the safe zone and sit tight there.
We do that right now.
Stepan, you're in charge while I'm away.
Oh, yes, sir.
Great. Let's go.
Is that a crater? Yeah. Yeah, that is a crater. Holy shit. I was like, those mountains look a little weird. Nah, this just seems like a trap. It's a trap! Is that a dam? Or a some sort of base?
Cars. Artyom was right. People were coming here from all over the country.
Oh, no, don't take the mask off.
Nobody came from Moscow.
I just forget, just press it down.
So much time wasted.
We'll make up for that now. Almost there.
Oh, no, this is a bad place. Now, we should not come here. Really?
Strong crest.
Okay, so where's my way?
Huh? Поехали.
Look.
Ooh.
Identify yourself.
Minister.
Here to report to the Minister of Defense.
And where are your people, Carl?
With the train.
It's dangerous outside. Contact them and tell them to take the train into the main airlock for decontamination. Welcome to the Ark, Colonel. Proceed through the tunnel and take the elevator. You'll be met inside.
See? We're expected.
Ooh, something wrong, man. I can feel it. Nothing is this easy. Nuclear warhead couldn't take out D6. You know what happened to that?
At least prepare a speech. Reporting to the minister is no joke.
Ah, get off my case. I pulled an all-nighter.
Don't you feel like you should say something to Artyom now?
Yes. You were right, Artyom. And I was wrong. Thanks for not giving up.
You might not thank me very soon, the way this is going. People behind the curtain, or another curtain, the window.
Comrade Minister, Commander of the Joint Special Operations Forces Squadron of the City of Moscow, Colonel Miller, reporting. I would like to request that my people are provided with temporary quarters and supplies, as there are women and children among us. Still, our fighters are in top shape and ready for action.
Women and children? Good. Haven't had those in a while.
Who are you?
Shit, I knew it. I fucking knew it. Someone took over the Ark, man.